time. Right now on the Tour de Trump, Thomas Craven, still the leader. Greg Horowitz of the Coors Light team in second spot. Soviet rider sliding in there in fifth place. And on the starting ramp right now, Alexei Graywall.
Few riders are as controversial as Alexei Graywall every year. He adds something new to the legend, and this year is no exception.
It is here in the Colorado High Country that Alexei Graywall has always flourished. He finds strength, both physical and spiritual, from these mountains near Boulder. But in the last year, he's found a new source of strength.
Oh, Christ in me. I am different. I am definitely different. Not by what I did. Because, you know, I didn't do anything, you know, and by what God did, by what Christ did for me, yeah, I'm different. There's no doubt about it. And in the past, which is fortunately is in the past, and I don't, you know, I do my best never to look back, you know, because it doesn't do any good. In the past, you know, I have been mercurial. I have been, you know, uptight. I have been, you know, I've lost my temper a lot, you know, and that's really due to the, you know, the way I grew up and the conditioning that you're put under by the world, you know, can form you. It does to everyone. My whole existence as a person just centered around whether or not I could, you know, blow their doors off in the bike races. And when I didn't, you know, it was a big blow to me. And my whole existence was, well, I got to win, I got to do this, I got to do that, you know, and therefore, you know, a lot of that stuff, you know, I mean, the stuff that was written about me, it's not, they're not lies, it's mostly true. I mean, almost everything that happened, happened, you know. But that's in the past. And the past is in the past.
A rider who more often than not has chosen his own path now has the world cycling stage from which to prove that he is indeed a changed man. Few people have moderate opinions on Alexei Graywall, but no matter how you view him, you must admit the man is interesting and he is someone that everyone in cycling loves to watch. He seems a little looser this year. Look at him working the crowd, Brian. We've not seen that before in a prologue from Alexei.
Well, we've seen him working the crowd, but it's usually been kind of the other way, a little bit negative perhaps, sticking his tongue out. And worse, Alexei Graywall on the course. Now, you know, again, the conditions. Alexei is not a favorite in the prologue time trial, but he certainly is one of the danger riders overall in this event. I think we cannot discount Alexei Graywall and the 1-2 punch of him with Greg LeMond on the same team.
No doubt about it, Brian. There aren't any hills to speak of in this prologue, and Alexei is not a prologue specialist anyway. I think what he wants to do today is just get into the race, prepare himself to support Greg LeMond in the days to come.
Alexei Graywall, you can see he's riding very smoothly, working hard, but here he's a little tentative. He sees a turn coming up. He sits up to watch and wait what's happening. He's out of the final turn and to the finish line. Over 5 minutes is time. 4:34 was the time for Thomas Craven. So Alexei Graywall is 71st when he goes across the line at 5:07.99.
Alexei Graywall will not be on the leaderboard today. We'll come right back from Albany with the Russians.
And Alexei hasn't had a strong...
When Alexei Graywall practices his violin, he knows painfully that to play well requires timing, coordination, and feeling. All these elements came together for him once before when he rode what he calls the perfect race, winning an Olympic gold before the home crowd in Los Angeles in 84, the first ever U.S. road racing gold.
It was the greatest race that I ever did, maybe that I'll ever ride. But when it was over, all the excitement and all the pleasure and everything that I got out of it was over the second I crossed the finish line. You know, and then the trappings of the world just flew in.
The press attention that focused on Alexei, combined with the rising expectations of the cycling world, changed what should have been a happy time into trauma, leaving Alexei feeling cornered and looking for a release.
A new car can make you happy, winning a race can make you happy, a good dinner can make you happy. At the same time, losing a race can make you sad. It's circumstance dictated, and I didn't want to be circumstance dictated all my life, so I started searching, and I looked at Buddhism, and I looked at Rajneeshism, and thisism, and thatism, and I wanted to find out the truth.
Though he never finished high school, the obviously bright Graywall took his search for privacy and escaped to this A-frame house in the mountains north of Boulder. The house is simply furnished. The only thing you find in the living room besides a stereo are Bibles. Bibles that have become important to Alexei in the last year as a newly reborn Christian.
If you want to know the truth about the whole situation, it's all written. And it just, for me, it brings incredible comfort and incredible peace because I know where to find the answers to any problem that comes up.
Since his gold medal in 84, Alexei has had his fair share of problems. He signed with a top European team after the Olympics, but never really fit, contracted hepatitis, and was forced home. He joined an American team that took him to the Tour de France with high expectations, but they were unfulfilled as he had to abandon the race. In last year's Coors race, he was back, serving as the player coach of a new team and battling his old teammates across the West. But again, angrily and painfully, he came up short. Now this year, he has a new team and a new teammate, Greg LeMond. The question for Graywall after all these years of frustration, does he have it in him? And can he perform for his new bosses?
Me to win races and be a contender. They didn't hire me to show up and finish 51st.
The unpredictable Alexei now has the Tour de Trump. Will he play to criticism or applause?
There, end of the concert.